So our thanks to Brad Levine. That, of course, was on location not too far from here, just a few blocks. We are back live now in the studio. I'm sure an awful lot of Canadians have at least toyed with the idea that they could go to Ottawa and at least do as good a job as the MPs who are here already. But it's a big leap from toying with that idea to actually trying to make it happen. So we'd like you to meet a couple of folks in our studio who are trying to do just that. Max Kahn is from Oakville, Ontario, and Kitchener's Karen Redmond. You may know her. She has served as an MP before under Jean Chrétien and Paul Martin. Both these folks, by the way, are Liberals, and they have to go through some training before they get thrown into the fray, and it's good to see you.
Thank you very much.
Good to be here.
You're the rookie here, Max. If I could start with you,
yes, what made you...
You've dabbled in municipal politics, it's a leap. What made you decide to do
this? Well, I mean, I was first elected in municipal politics in 2006, and I've been quite involved in the Oakville community. I got re-elected in October.
As city councillor.
Mm-hmm. And it's just another venue. I mean, I've represented people at the local level. Now I can take their concerns, hopefully, from Oakville to Ottawa, and hopefully make a difference in our community.
Now, is this, you're doing this as a personal challenge, or are you doing this as a mission to change the world in which you live?
You know what, it's not necessarily change the world. I mean, you can change, you know, the lives of a few people, and for them, you've changed the world. So I think it's a bit of both. It's a personal challenge as well, and it also is to make a difference in my community.
You were an MP, you were out of the business for a couple of years, and now you're coming back. Why would you do that?
Didn't get enough? Because, first of all, it's the best job in the world. I mean, who else goes to work every day and makes decisions that impact the quality of Canadians' lives and then gets to come home and watch you on TV and watch the 6 o'clock news and see what happened that day? Mm-hmm. So it's a fabulous job. And I, too, started out in municipal politics. I started as a trustee, and then I was on city and regional council in the city of Kitchener for Waterloo Region. And I think by doing that, Dan, you get the journeyman work, and you also realize the profound improvement impact you can have on people's lives. And I think that's what keeps us coming back.
You were a Liberal in your first time
through
Ottawa.
I am a Liberal.
You are in nonpartisan politics at the moment as a city councillor.
Right.
So you have options. You have chosen Liberals.
I have chosen Liberals.
And you did that because how do they speak to you?
Well, you know what, it's not that I necessarily chose a Liberal, becoming a Liberal now. I've been Liberal for years. Mm-hmm. And I think that they have loftier policies, loftier philosophies, and the goals that they're trying to achieve are not just national goals, but they're international goals. And I think we can make a difference on the international stage. And, I am bleeding Liberal, and I believe that we have a lot to contribute.
So the big red tent, that's aptly named for you.
That's right.
What are the challenges of being an MP?
I think the work-life balance is always a challenge. You come to Ottawa and you get very immersed. Being out of the
Ottawa
bubble.
Helpful when the kids are grown, huh?
Well, you absolutely have to have a supportive husband or a wife. And we have 4 children who are grown now, but I used to buy my husband Mother's Day gifts because he became Mr. Mom when I came to Ottawa. But I really think that It's the lure of being able to make a difference. Mm-hmm. And I think the challenge sometimes is people come, whether you're focused on the environment or something very specific, and what you recognize is the difference between having power and having influence. And I came under Mr. Chrétien, and I had the privilege of being a parliamentary secretary to David Anderson, who was the Minister of Environment. I got to be there when Kyoto got ratified. I went to Washington when we tabled the undertaking that we would be part of that initiative. And you get to do things that impact the next generation, and it's a wonderful experience. Mm.
Now, if you aspire to be part of that, you're going to have to stand out of the crowd. There's a lot of people here who want to be part of that.
Right.
How do you stand out in this crowd?
I think one of the things, I think the Liberals parties can stand out because to a greater extent in our party, we have the right to dissent. We have independent voices. You'll see all of our MPs and all of our candidates speaking from their hearts. And I think that makes a difference. And I think that touches a chord with Canadians. When I go to speak in different venues in Oakville, I'll discuss the issues that they're concerned about, not necessarily bring to Oakville issues that Ottawa's concerned about, but a grassroots movement up. And I think that makes a difference.
So what are you learning in this training camp? What is it you're learning to do?
It's not really a training camp, you know, Dan.
Wrong word?
Well, not wrong word, but it's winter caucus, so our caucus colleagues, the Liberals, will be here for the next couple of days. We have about 100 candidates. Some people, like Max and I, have been candidates for a year or more, and we have somebody in the room who I think's been a candidate for, nominated 4 days ago?
Yep.
So it's wonderful to feel part of a team. It's great to see the tools that the party has for us us to use. It's wonderful to know that you're part of a communications plan. So, and the leader came in, and yeah. I mean, it's just a very positive, great vibe. So it's really nice to come and feel renewed when you go back and start knocking on doors in your constituency.
You share this feeling. Have you been impressed by the quality of people that you meet here and want to do stuff for Canada?
I do, and it is a great opportunity to meet them. You know, as you said, that with other candidates, some of them have been. The one gentleman that I was sitting beside had been involved for 7 elections. So you get to pick their brains about, you know, different campaign strategies.
7 elections.
I won't say the name. campaign strategies, marketing.
Of course, they're every 2 years now.
That's right.
Did anyone warn you about that?
a little bit about social media, and we were discussing that off air. We reviewed some of the relevant portions of the legislation, the Elections Canada Act, and I think that was very important. It was a good opportunity for us to come together and go forward with a strategy.
Did anyone tell you when the election's going to be?
I thought you got that memo.
Yeah, actually, Dan, all we can do is tell you, and you may want to write this down, is that there will be an election. We just don't know when.
Sooner or later. Karen Redmond, MaxCon, nice to see you.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you very much.
Thanks very much.
Brian Mulroney.